Good morning, all of you. So before I start my talk, I'd like to thank Director IITM and the members of the committee for selecting this paper for this award. I would also like to thank my co-authors, Dr. R. Krishnan especially, who has been my guide and mentor for the past 13 years since I joined as a student, M.V.S. Ramarao, Dr. Vellore, Manmeet, and of course Brian Mapes for their contributions to this paper. Now, as Vrinda has already told, this paper entitled A Phenomenological Paradigm for Mid-Tropospheric Cyclogenesis in the Indian Summer Monsoon is published in JAS last year. So you all know that the South Asian monsoon circulation is a large-scale convectively coupled phenomena and is characterized by the reversal of the winds and precipitation regime over the North Indian Ocean and adjoining land areas. Now, these are the So this is the right-hand panel shows the boreal winter conditions over the region, and the left-hand panel shows the boreal summer conditions. The upper panel shows the upper level winds and precipitation, and the lower panel shows the lower level winds, the sea level pressure and SSTs. So we see that during the boreal winter months, the upper level is dominated by westerly winds, and in the lower level we have circulation outflow of wind from the continental region towards the equatorial Indian Ocean, where the convergence occurs and the precipitation maxima lies over the equatorial Indian Ocean. In the summer monsoon months, the land-sea thermal contrast sets up the monsoon circulation. We have cross-equatorial winds which emanate from the Mascarian High. It crosses the equator, forms the organizes and forms the Somali jet, and interacts with the Himalaya to form a cyclonic vortex called the monsoon trough. These winds transport moisture from the oceanic regions into the subcontinent, gives rise to the moisture convergence over the monsoon trough and the deep cloud cover. As the monsoon evolves, the latent heat released from these cloud cover, it maintains the monsoon circulation. Now, embedded in the large-scale monsoon circulation are various synoptic scale disturbances, like the monsoon lows and depressions, which usually occur over Head Bay of Bengal and move inland. Sometimes we have the onset vortex over the Arabian Sea. We have mid-tropospheric cyclones, which occur over Western India. We also have the northward propagating organized rain belt, which gives rise to the active break cycles of the monsoon. The genesis, organization and movement of these systems, along with oscillations of the large-scale features, controls the rainfall variability over the subcontinent. Now, mid-tropospheric cyclones are a very unique quasi-stationary circulation which are confined to the mid-tropospheric levels, and they almost have a non-existent surface signature. This was first identified by the seminal paper in Miller and Keshav Murthy in the year 1968 during the International Indian Ocean Expedition. Now, the system has a vorticity structure maxima between 700 and 500 HPA levels. It has a horizontal scale of about 1000 kilometers and a vertical scale of 6 to 8 kilometers. It has strong mid-level convergence and vertical upward motions. And the temperature structure shows warming above 500 HPA levels and cooling below that level. So usually these systems sometimes are observed over the Indochina regions, sometimes over North Bay of Bengal, but their most preferred location of occurrence is over Western India. This is a typical MTC circulation for the year 2007, which occurred from 31st July to 7th August. This is a 600 HPA circulation. We see a nice circulation located at Northeast Arabian Sea. Now we take a look at the 1963 MTC, which was reported by Miller and Keshav Murthy. It's a quite a famous MTC. And we see again a very nice cyclonic circulation at 600 millibar, just north of Bombay. And associated surface circulation does not show any signature of a cyclonic circulation, but there are strong southwesterly winds over Arabian Sea. Now, if we take a cross-section of, vertical cross-section along the center of the cyclonic circulation, we see, and this is the divergence and vorticity profiles for these cross-sections. So, we see that the divergence as well as vorticity across these cross-sections are located, the maximum divergence and vorticity are located between 700 to 500 millibar levels. Now, these systems produce very heavy rainfall over Western India. As an example, we'll talk about 2019 monsoon, where there were very heavy rainfall events occurred over Bombay. So we had 5 extreme rainfall days at IMD Santa Cruz, Santa Cruz Observatory. So basically, by extreme heavy rainfall days, it is like the 24-hour accumulated rainfall was more than 200 millimeters. And we found that many of these days, the IMD also reported the presence of a quasi-stationary mid-level cyclonic circulation over North Konkan and adjoining South Gujarat region. So now we'll take a look at the atmospheric conditions that prevailed during one of these heavy rainfall days. That is, this is the 29 June event. So we'll take 28, this 2 p.m. cloud picture over this monsoon region. So we see 2 distinct convective centers, one over Northeast Arabian Sea adjoining Western Ghats, another over North Bay, Central Bay of Bengal. Also, we see very clear sky condition over this subtropical West Asian region. Now, the same day, 28 June, IMD Weather Inference reported the presence of a cyclonic circulation between 3 to 7 kilometers over North Konkan and adjoining South Gujarat region. The GFS 12 kilometer winds for 00 GMT on 28 June also showed the presence of a cyclonic circulation located over North Maharashtra, adjoining South Gujarat region. Also, we had northwesterly winds over Afghanistan, Pakistan region. Now, the 925 HPA, that is the lower level winds, we don't see any cyclonic circulation over this region, but we see very strong southwesterly winds. And these atmospheric conditions resulted in the very high rainfall accumulation over Mumbai. That is 235 millimeter for the day. Now, we take a look at the previous year, that is 2018. So, this figure here shows the subdivisional rainfall anomaly percentage departures for week ending 28 July 2018. So, again, we see over the subdivisions of Saurashtra, Kutch, Gujarat, interior Maharashtra, very heavy rainfall departures. So, Saurashtra, Kutch has 230% rainfall departure, Gujarat has 107%. And interior Maharashtra has 136%. During the same week, IMD also reported a presence of a mid-level cyclonic circulation between 3 to 7 kilometers, which was located in South Gujarat and adjoining areas. And there were also reports of heavy flooding and people had to be shifted to safer places. Now we go back in time a bit and we look into an event of 2005. This was a classical mid-tropospheric cyclonic event which occurred from 29 June to 3rd July. Now, again, this event was associated with heavy floods over the entire state of Gujarat. So, these are rainfall and percentage departures for the subdivisions of Saurashtra Kutch, and this one is for Gujarat. We see that week ending June 29th and July 6th, there was heavy rainfall over Saurashtra Kutch. The rainfall departure was more than 200% for the entire 2 weeks. Also, over Gujarat region, there was extreme heavy precipitation. It was more than 450 to 50 millimeters per day over the subdivision, and the rainfall departure was more than 300% for both the weeks. During the same period, we also looked into the TRMM swaths for that event, and we found large-scale organized convective activity of mesoscale convective systems which produced this heavy deluge. Now, for our study, we analyzed the heaviest 3-day rain accumulations from TRMM 3B42 for the decade 1998 to 2007. And we found that over various grids in Western India, the record precipitation accumulations, 3-day record precipitation accumulations for this decade occurred in the presence of a mid-level cyclonic circulation. Therefore, we can say that these MTCs are associated with flooding and heavy precipitation over Western India. So, for reliable outlook of these heavy precipitating events over Western India, we need to understand the genesis mechanisms of these systems. Now, over the years, there has been limited studies regarding these MTCs. So, in 1966, Ramage proposed that the MTCs was formed due to intensification of the monsoon heat low and export of cyclonic vorticity from that region. Later, Mack said that this resulted because of a special class of baroclinic instability, and he also highlighted the importance of condensational heating. But the horizontal shear that was needed for that baroclinic instability was unrealistically high, what we don't usually observe in nature. Also, his simulated MTC was at a lower levels. Krishnamurti, Hawkins and Carr, they showed that once the MTC is set in, then the latent heat released from cumulus convection, it maintains the circulation. But in recent years, there were very limited studies on this system. So phenomenological understanding of the basic mechanisms behind the genesis of the MTC was not explored. With the availability of TRMM observations and various reanalysis data sets, we investigated the possible linkage between the formation of an MTC over Northeast Arabian Sea and the northward propagating organized monsoon convection on subseasonal timescales. We also looked into the role of latent heating from these organized precipitating systems in formation of the MTC. Now, for our study, we selected mid-level cyclonic circulation events based on IMD's weather summary, and we also considered the events which was quasi-stationary over Gujarat for 5 days or more during the period 1988 to 2008, and we took only cases which was heavily precipitating over this western Indian region. So this led to the identification of 20 MTC cases for our study. The right-hand panel here shows the anomalous circulation, low-level, mid-level and the rainfall. And this is the composite for the mean circulation, the low-level, mid-level and the rainfall. So we see during the MTC event, there are strong southwesterly winds over the Arabian Sea. Also, we see a signature of the monsoon trough over Head Bay. At mid-level, we see a east-west oriented circulation gyre with two cyclonic centers, one over Northeast Arabian Sea and one over North Bay of Bengal. Now, this is very prominent in the mid-level circulation. The presence of this intensified vorticity over Bay of Bengal suggests that these heavily precipitating MTCs usually co-occur with a low or depression over the eastern region. And we have verified that out of the 20 cases, 18 cases actually there was a low and depression which moved inland. The rainfall composites show heavy precipitation over western India and North Maharashtra and adjoining coastal regions. We have widespread rainfall activity over central India as well as over Bay of Bengal. Now, in order to understand the formation mechanism of these systems, we looked into the day-to-day evolution of circulation and precipitation anomalies for the MTC cases. Here, day zero is the day when the MTC was first reported over Gujarat, and it remains quasi-stationary for 5 days or more. Now, we have considered from day minus three, that is day 3 days previous to the formation of the event, and till day seven. So we see before the MTC was reported over Gujarat, there is a cyclonic circulation over central Arabian Sea. It extends across peninsular India into southeast Bay of Bengal. Also, we can see a developing anticyclone over the subtropical West Asian region. The onset of the MTC is marked by intensification of this cyclonic circulation over Northeast Arabian Sea and intensification of this anticyclone. This forms a north-south oriented quasi-stationary cyclone-anticyclone pair. In the subsequent days, by day two, we have two cyclonic centers, one over Arabian Sea, Northeast Arabian Sea, and other overhead Bay of Bengal. Also, in the subsequent days, this anticyclonic circulation intensifies and thereon it dissipates. And we have an east-west oriented cyclonic gyre which extends from Arabian Sea across peninsular India into North Bay of Bengal. Now, if we look into the circulation precipitation anomalies, we see that before the MTC formed, there are precipitation enhancements which occur over central Arabian Sea, adjoining coastal regions. And also, there is a propagating, northward propagating organized rain belt over Bay of Bengal. As the MTC onset happens, precipitation increases over the west coast and this North Maharashtra region. And during the mature stage of the MTC, that is day 4 onwards, we see systematic increase of precipitation over Gujarat, Saurashtra, Kutch and North Maharashtra region. So we wanted to know what is the role of this increase in precipitation over Central Arabian Sea, coastal West Coast region, as well as this northward movement of the rain belt, so which occurs prior to the onset of the MTC. So we know that the precipitation over tropics can be partitioned into convective and stratiform rain. So the convective rain essentially occurs from young active convection, wherein the vertical velocities are several meters per second, and they are identified as intense peaks in reflectivities in the radar echoes. And stratiform rain usually occurs from older mature convection, which is supported by gentler upward motions, and the it is identified from the bright band in the reflectivity. The heating profiles for these two type of rainfall are distinctly different. The convective rainfall gives a positive heating for the and all the vertical levels with a single mid-tropospheric condensational heating peak, whereas the stratiform rain has a heating peak at the upper levels and a cooling peak lower. Now, with the availability of the TRMM vertical profiles of precipitation, retrievals have algorithms have calculated the heating latent heating profiles over the entire tropics. Now, this is an example of the 5-year mean heating over the tropical region from TRMM observations. So, the lower panel gives the surface rain rate, and the upper panel gives the heatings for different vertical levels. This is for 2 kilometers, 5 kilometers, and 8 kilometers. So, we see that the tropical heavy precipitating regions show a heating peak at the upper levels. So, basically, these regions are dominated by stratiform precipitation. Studies have partitioned the precipitation over the Indian monsoon region into stratiform and convective contributions. So, the right-hand panel here shows the climatological JJA stratiform rain and percentage contribution. The left-hand panel shows the JJA's convective contribution and the convective percentages. So, we can see that over the central India, Bay of Bengal and eastern regions, there is higher percentages of stratiform rain, whereas climatologically this west coast is a region where we have lower stratiform rain. Okay, so in order to understand what is the role of the heating from the precipitating systems over western this Arabian Sea and western Ghats, what is its contribution to the formation of MTC, we analyzed heating profiles from TRMM observations. We have considered whenever there was a TRMM swath over MCS during day minus 3, minus 2 and minus 1, we have averaged the heating for the raining grids and shown it here. So, we got 8 samples for our study period, and we see that all of the profiles show enhanced heating in the upper levels, that is above 600 HPA, and the heating maxima it as 400 HPA level, that is about 7 kilometers. This top heavy heating structure with heating above mid levels and cooling below, it indicates that the precipitating systems have abundant stratiform rain in it. Now, studies have already shown that stratiform heating profile is crucial in intensifying the mid to upper level circulation. Shoemaker and House showed that intensification of the Walker cell occurs due to stratiform heating, and Choudhury and Krishnan, we showed that the vertical development of the monsoon trough occurred in the presence of stratiform heating. So, we wanted to know what is the role of the stratiform heating from organized MCS occurring over Arabian Sea and the Western Ghats in MTC formation. Now, we already saw northward moving organized rain belt in the Bay of Bengal, which showed that the formation of MTC might be linked to the northward movement of organized convection on subseasonal time scale. For this, we analyzed the OLR anomalies. So, this is the OLR anomaly for days previous to the formation of the MTC. We see large scale organized convection prior to the commencement of MTC from Bay of Arabian Sea across the Indian landmass to South Bay of Bengal. Also, we see that these negative OLR anomalies are flanked by positive OLR anomalies to the north and this is associated with the surface heat low, which is capped in the mid-troposphere by a subsidence. So to identify the importance of the subseasonal convective signal, we use the 10 to 90 day filtered anomalies with respect to the onset date of the MTC. So we plotted the OLR anomalies with respect to day 0. So we say much ahead of the onset of MTC at day minus 12, we have intense convective activities over equatorial Indian Ocean, particularly the eastern side, and on subsequent days it propagates northward, and we see by day minus 6 and minus 3 there are two convective centers, one over Central Arabian Sea, East Arabian Sea and southwest Bay of Bengal in the subsequent days, and also we see this intensification of this positive OLR anomalies over subtropical West Asia. As the band moves north and it intensifies, this anomalies also intensify. So by day 3 we have the maximum negative anomalies located over Western India, as well as we have this over the Bay of Bengal. Now to look into the northward propagating signal, we did a half molar plot. We averaged the OLR anomalies between 60 to 100 degree east and plotted it with respect to the onset date of the MTC. So this side we have the MTC days, and this is the latitude. So we see a clear northward propagation of organized convection from equator at day minus 12 to about 20 degrees with a speed of 1 degree per day. Now, it is known that convection over this peninsular India and Bay of Bengal, it produces subsidence over this subtropical West Asian region. And subsidence over subtropical anticyclone regions are associated with intense radiative cooling. So, we looked into the radiative cooling anomalies from MERA data for days prior to and during the onset of the event. We see that there are intense radiative cooling associated with this mountainous regions of Afghanistan, Iran, Turkmenistan region, which intensified, spreads during after the onset of the MTC, and it actually reaches the peak at day 2, and then subsequently it decreases. So we can say that the formation of MTC happens in an environment of northward propagating organized convection, which is enriched with stratiform precipitating systems over this Arabian Sea and Western Ghats, as well as a subsidence to the north of it. Now, to identify the role of these heating and cooling anomalies in formation of the system, we conducted some simulation experiments using a simple general circulation model. Now, this is a simple global atmospheric model that we have used, which we have forced with a specified heating and obtained the 100 days response, the steady state response at 100 days of model run. Now, to calculate the 3D latent heating profiles, we use the Shoemaker's algorithm. So, we use the rainfall at a grid, partitioned it into its stratiform and convective components. Then we took the assumed latent heating profiles of stratiform and convective rain, linearly combined them with the based on that precipitation percentages, stratiform and convective precipitation percentages at that grid point, normalized them and multiplied them with the rain rate at the grid. So for the climatological, that is a control run, we used the climatological TRMM 3A25 surface rain estimates and the stratiform convective rainfall percentages. So this is the vertically averaged JJ's latent heating that we derived using the Shoemaker algorithm. So we see the heating maxima over Western Ghats as well as over Bay of Bengal off the Myanmar coast associated with the precipitation maxima. The enhanced heating is between 10 to 25 degree latitude belt, and it is associated with the large scale monsoon convection. So using this three dimensional heating, we force the model. So the circulation response for the control experiment shows an east-west oriented mid-tropospheric cyclonic circulation with its maxima over head bay. Now to identify the individual and combined influence of the different heating anomalies, we designed three sensitivity experiments. So in the first experiment, we wanted to see what is the contribution of latent heating from the MCS activity over Arabian Sea and Western Ghats region to the formation of the system. So for that, what we did was we composited the rainfall anomalies for days -3, -2, -1. Then we extracted the rainfall anomalies over this region and used conservative estimates based on earlier studies, that is 40% of stratiform and 60% of convective over this entire grid. And using the same Shoemaker algorithm, we constructed the anomalous heating profiles. So this is a representative heating profile over a grid in the Western Ghats with 40% stratiform. So it shows a heating peak at 400 HPA. We have two additional heating profiles here. One is with higher stratiform rain fraction, that is 75 stratiform rain fraction, and another with a lower stratiform rain fraction, that is 10%. So we see as we introduce more stratiform rain into the heating peak shifts up, and we have a very strong mid-level heating gradient at 500 HPA level. So alongside, we have the mean CSH retrieval heating profiles. So we see that the vertical structure of higher stratiform profiles, it is similar to the CSH retrieved profiles. So we take this anomalous heating and we add it to the climatological JJS latent heating. This gives us the heating profile for the Arabian Sea experiment. Now for the next experiment, we introduce the radiative cooling over this region when it was maximum. So we extract the radiative cooling from Mera 2, the 3D radiative cooling, and add it along with the Arabian Sea heating to the climatological JJS heating. So in experiment 2, we have one heat source over Arabian Sea and we have a cooling anomalies over the West Asian region. For the third experiment, we take the rainfall anomalies over the Bay of Bengal region for same -3, -2, -1. We construct the heating anomalies similarly and we add it to the climatological heating. So for the third experiment, basically we have two heat sources, one over Arabian Sea, one over Bay of Bengal, and we have a cooling anomalies over the West Asian region. Now, using these three heating profiles, we run the model and obtain the steady state response and compare the results with the control simulation. So this is the mid-level anomalous circulation response for all the three experiments. So we see that in the Arabian Sea experiment, there is intensification of a cyclonic circulation over the North Arabian Sea, as well as we see a developing anticyclone to the north of it. Now, as we introduce the radiative cooling in the system, this forms a ridge over this region. It sharpens the feature and closes off this North Arabian Sea cyclonic circulation. Now, when we add the Bay of Bengal heating into the system, there is a large-scale intensification of the entire monsoon mid-level circulation. It has a very nice cyclonic vortex at North Arabian Sea, as well as there is intensification of this anticyclonic circulation over West Asia. This can be interpreted as a Rossby wave response to the monsoon convection. Now, to understand the role of stratiform rain in producing this mid-tropospheric cyclones, we conduct two additional experiments. That is, in one experiment, we have increased the stratiform rain over the for this Arabian Sea region, that is, for this Arabian Sea and Western Ghats precipitation anomalies. And in another, we have decreased the stratiform rain to 10%. So we have more convective rain in that experiment. So we find when we have very high stratiform rain fractions, there is intensification of this mid-level cyclonic circulation, but the surface signature does not show any circulation. But when we have a more of convective rain in the system, we see that the mid-level circulation, anomalous circulation is weak, whereas intensification occurs in the lower level. So we can say that the stratiform rainfall in the MCS over Arabian Sea and Western Ghats is very crucial in generating this mid-tropospheric cyclonic circulation over Northeast Arabian Sea. Now these are the divergence and heat vorticity profiles over the MTC region for different experiments. So this is the control experiment. This is the profile for the control experiment. So here we have lower level convergence, which is capped by divergence above 700 HPA. But for all the other three experiments, the convergence increases till 500 HPA. So there is a gradual build up of convergence from this 850 to 500 HPA levels. So this basically is a response to the heating associated with the stratiform rain. The maximum heating gradient at the mid-tropospheric levels is produces this convergence, and we can see associated intensification of vorticity from 700 to 500 HPA levels in the vorticity profiles. So now this is a vertical structure of the geopotential heat anomaly, height anomaly, sorry. So we see that negative height anomalies are centered over Central Arabian Sea, and it is confined to 700 HPA to 400 HPA levels. The vertical structure of the vertical velocity shows high vertical upward motions east of the system and confined to around 400 to 300 HPA. This is also seen in the reported by Miller and Keshav Murthy in their paper. So based on these results, we can we developed a conceptual sequence of mechanisms, the processes which leads to the development of the MTC. So we found that the formation of MTCs have a dependence on the slow northward propagating organized rain belts, which is enriched with stratiform type of precipitating mesoscale systems. These stratiform precipitation, it has a maximum heating gradient at 400 HPA and a very maximum heating at 400 HPA and a very strong heating gradient at mid levels. So which is a source of PV. So therefore this heating gradient, it generates the cyclonic vortex directly, and this is the convergence. Mid level convergence is very high, so this high convergence produces the enhanced relative vorticity in mid-tropospheric levels through vorticity stretching. Now, based on this conceptual sequence of mechanism, we take a look at the 28 June conditions. So this was the cloud picture for 28 June 2019. So we had two convection centers, one over Northeast Arabian Sea and one over Central Bay of Bengal. And we had very clear sky conditions over this subtropical West Asian region. And if we looked into the weather inference of IMD, we found that 27 June, they reported that there was a cyclonic circulation which was over North Konkan and adjoining South Gujarat region between 3 to 7 kilometers, which persisted in the next few days till few days in the first week of July. So third July also, they reported the presence of the cyclonic circulation over South Gujarat and neighborhood between 2 to 6 kilometers. So now, so we take 27 June when it was reported over Gujarat as the first day. So we look into the conditions of 24th June, that is day minus 3, and 25th June, that is day minus 2. So these are snapshots of OLR and the multi-satellite GPM daily precipitation. This is the OLR and this is the precipitation. So we can see a developing convection over western, over Arabian Sea and the west coast region and associated precipitation rates. We also see a convection, organized convection over south of Bay of Bengal and very clear sky conditions in subtropical West Asia. So this persists in 25th June, the precipitation picks up over this Arabian Sea and Arabian Sea region. Also, we have this organized rain belt, and the clear sky conditions intensifies on 25th June. Now, this is for 26th July, that is day minus 1. We see that this convective activity, it has organized into an MCS, and the precipitation rainfall has intensified over Arabian Sea, Central Arabian Sea and associated Western Ghats region. Also, this clear sky conditions persist, and on 26 June, actually, IMD also reported the presence of a mid-level cyclonic circulation over Central Arabian Sea, which we see in the GFS winds of 26 June 00 GMT. So we have a mid-level cyclonic circulation over Central and East Arabian Sea, and therefore, So this is the 28 June conditions which we had looked earlier. So we see very deep convection over Northeast Arabian Sea and over Central Bay of Bengal, and intense clear sky conditions over the subtropical West Asian region. And we see very high precipitation rates, which was responsible for the intense rainfall over this North Maharashtra region. We have precipitation, intense precipitation over this Arabian Sea adjoining West Coast region, as well as over North Bay of Central Bay of Bengal. And associated, we have already seen that 28 June, the IMD winds, the GFS winds, it showed a nice cyclonic circulation at mid-level centered over Mumbai. So we can summarize the results as the formation of MTCs over North Arabian Sea is an aspect of the broad monsoon circulation, which has a dependence on the slow northward moving organized convection on subseasonal timescales. This rain belt is enriched with stratiform type of precipitating systems, which has a top heavy heating profile, but is also aided by the high pressure anomalies over subtropical West Asia. But the main highlight of the study is the crucial role of the stratiform type of heating in producing the mid-level cyclonic circulation over Gujarat. So, therefore, we can say that the models need to simulate this stratiform type of heating for better forecast of the extreme precipitation events over the region. But we know that the linkage of the stratiform and convective heating processes, it still remains a fundamental challenge for most of the climate and NWP models. So we need to have better cumulus parameterizations for better forecast of these extreme rain events over Western India. Thank you.